Hey, what's going on, guys? It's been a while since I made a video like this, and just giving my thoughts on a situation, like kind of like a podcast style with minimal jump cuts, where you know this is something that you can enjoy while you're at work or on the way or from work, you know, while you're, you know, making love, however you want to consume the content, but just more of a long form thing, and just giving my unfiltered opinions because I haven't really gathered too much information about the VOD adpocalypse, but for what I do know about it, I just kind of wanted to give my two cents on the situation. And before I jump into that, a lot of people have been hitting me up on social media, on Twitter, Instagram, whatnot, asking me, hey, how come you haven't been making as much content? And I'm going to make a separate video addressing, like, updating everything and what's been going on. But it's nothing too crazy. It's just that, like, just to give a little brief explanation is, around the spring of each year, you know, since I've only been on YouTube and, like, I've only really blown up since 2016. But in 2017 around spring and 2018 around spring, my channel goes in this algorithmic abyss. It just takes a nosedive. And I start losing subs consistently. Every time I upload, I lose a lot of subs. I'm not in recommended. People complain about not seeing me in the subscriptions, and my videos perform poorly. It's just something that I usually have to ride out, and then it's just kind of over in a few weeks, and then the channel returns to normal. This has been a little bit different this time around because this year it's been going on for longer than a month, and I've been losing like I've lost over a couple thousand subs, and it just hasn't been looking good. You can kind of just take a look at my channel and see when the drop off went for everything was normal, and then it just took a nosedive. And so because of that, I just haven't been uploading as much because I just want to just kind of wait it out. But I'm not even sure if the storm is going to be waited out. This might be the fate of my channel. You know, I've seen this happen to other people before. But I'm working on other things, but I digress. I just want to get that out of the way. Now I want to talk about the VOD adpocalypse that everybody's kind of been talking about and buzzing about. And I didn't know too much about it. You know, it's between this guy that works for Vox named Carlos Maza. I'm pretty sure that's how you pronounce his last name. And Steven Crowder. Now, most of you know who Steven Crowder is. He's this conservative comedian edgelord. And, you know, I know a lot of people would say he's not a comedian, but, you know, comedy is subjective, and obviously he is a comedian. All he does is just try to be funny and give you his point of view through, you know, he wants you to see the world how he sees it with comedy, and, you know, kind of being somewhat of a political pundit at the same time. And then Carlos Maza, the only thing I've really known about him is just what's been happening recently, and then just seeing a little bit of tidbits that people kind of posted on Twitter, kind of showing this guy and his profile that he's like a Marxist, and he thinks, you know, everybody that works at Fox News is a white supremacist. Obviously Tucker Carlson, a lot of his content is just, you know, taking shots of them, which is fine. I mean, there's plenty of people that make content that take shots at other news outlets, media outlets like the Young Turks or whatnot. It's just a frenzy, you know. So he also is a fan of deplatforming. And this is what this is all about. He's on a mission to deplatform Steven Crowder. He saw how effective it was to deplatform Alex Jones and people like that. So because Steven Crowder has been making fun of him for a long time, you know, refuting some of his videos or making these rebuttals or whatnot, obviously Carlos doesn't like that. And he's brought it to YouTube's attention to really show that, hey, this guy's been harassing me and all this stuff, and people have been doxing me and all this, you know, a lot of things that some, like a very small percentage of people will do. There's always those people out there that will go to the extreme, and then all of a sudden, Steven Crowder takes the blame, even though it's not his fault. It's not like Steven Crowder is actually coming out there and saying, hey, I want you to dox this guy, I want you to do this and that. But Carlos knows this. He's using this as his advantage. And he also knows that it's Pride Month, and so he's gonna try to go as hard as he can. He's gonna go hard in the paint as much as possible to try to get this done. And all you really need to see is this little clip that has been shown, that has been shared around a lot, to really show you his agenda.
A ton of people have talked about this way before I did, and I've experienced it way worse than I have. YouTube is dominated by alt-right monsters who use the platform to target their critics and make their lives miserable. It's been happening for a long time. It's been happening since way before me. The response from people who've experienced this is, yeah, I agree. to hell with YouTube. I can't believe they're branding themselves as Pride Allies. And I heard you have Raymond Brown coming up later on the show. I hope you ask him what it's like to make basically corporate propaganda for a company that doesn't care about queer people. The response from critics, people who love Steven Crowder, have been that I'm a fascist and I'm an NBC plant trying to take down a competitor, which is like so dumb. I don't know what to say to it. But it's meant to distract from the reality, which is that Steven Crowder is not the problem. Alex Jones isn't the problem. These individual actors are not the problem. They are symptoms and the product of YouTube's design, which is meant to reward the most inflammatory, bigoted, and engaging performers. Steven Crowder is YouTube's ideal creator. He makes cheap, long content that tons of people watch and subscribe to. He sells shirts on the platform that say socialism is for fags, which YouTube continues to allow. He is what an ideal YouTube creator looks like.
So you can see what he's doing by saying that YouTube is dominated by just alt-right monsters, which is ridiculous. Obviously, YouTube is dominated by vloggers, you know, Viners, and just people that are in the beauty community and stuff. Like, that's what YouTube is all about. That's where the tens of millions of views per day is being generated. And then you have a very small pocket of political people that are making a tiny fraction of that. It's just wordplay, and obviously saying that Steven Crowder is YouTube's ideal creator, like, that's incredibly silly. It's a really stupid thing to say, but obviously he isn't making that video, or he isn't saying that stuff for people like me. He's not saying that for the people that he's ideologically opposed to. He's saying this for the people that agree with him, you know, the progressive ideologues that are hanging on his every word, and they're going to just nod their head like yes men. And that's exactly what's been happening. And there's also one other thing at play. You know, obviously, not only is he trying to destroy Steven Crowder, there's some other stuff going on with Vox. You know, it seems like there's been a strike, and I'm going to talk about that more later and see maybe if that possibly ties into why he chose this really important time, not only Pride Month, but just, hey, there's probably a strike happening. We need to get as much attention to Vox as possible. And we'll see if there's any connection on that. But more importantly, why people are talking about hashtag VODadpocalypse is because of what YouTube has been doing. YouTube has been kind of diligent for a long time, or I guess diligent is the wrong word to use, because diligent is usually supposed to be something positive. But they have been taking a lot of steps to kind of just do things to their platform that would make advertisers more happy, and that would make the progressive ideologues more happy, you know, which is, that's what Silicon Valley is, that's what they represent. So obviously that's going to be the main focus, to make sure they're happy, so the tech companies and everything will be happy. And creators have been suffering for it for a long time. As a matter of fact, I remember quite a long time ago, it was probably late 2015, was the first time I noticed that a couple of my videos were getting demonetized. This was way before any adpocalypse happened. This is like, say, oh, if you're talking about certain words, if you're talking about certain subjects, like, you know, anything that has to do with Islam, you know, whether it's good or bad, it just got caught in the algorithm, and they're like, this is not advertiser friendly, and then you don't even have a chance to review it. That was long time ago. That was almost 3 years ago. Oh, wait, what am I saying? Almost 3 years ago. It was almost 4 years ago. So, and then things progressively rolled out. So YouTube has had this technology, and then they've been tuning it and making it in a certain way. And it seems like something stupid keeps happening that forces their hand even sooner than they wanted to roll the things out. So it seems like YouTube has always had the plan to do these things, but I think they're just doing them prematurely. It's kind of like, it's seeming like what's happening now. Obviously Vox has been, not Vox, but YouTube has been cracking down on hate speech. They've been doing this for a while, and they've been rolling things out. Now they're like, oh, anything that talks about flat earth theory, anti-vax and whatnot, it's going to be suppressed. And anything that seems anything, I've noticed that certain videos that have certain subjects, they put like a little Wikipedia article to kind of explain what is about, to kind of like maybe even almost refute what the video may be about, because I've just seen people talk about certain subjects, like somebody shitting on anti-vaxxers, and because it's in there, the algorithm thinks, oh, this is an anti-vax video. And then there's like a little article, a little like wiki thing, kind of showing you, just giving you some information just in case you may be led astray or whatnot. And so it's a problem. Creators are being creators are suffering because of these decisions that YouTube is making to please advertisers and stuff, because I mean, they have to have some type of stream coming. But it sucks because the advertisers know this, and they're the ones getting the upper hand, because once some big thing happens, they can just leave, and then they can negotiate their ads again and be like, okay, we're gonna get them for cheaper, we're gonna pay you less, and then so it's less money for everybody, but YouTube still gets a bigger sum, so at least they get something rather than nothing. And that's a big problem. And the worst thing about this is that Carlos doesn't care about that stuff. That is not what he's about. He's about deplatforming. As he said, deplatforming works, and he wants Steven Crowder deplatform. So when YouTube made the decision to demonetize Crowder, he wasn't happy with it. He was actually angry, like, oh, that's it? He makes his money through his Mug Club subscription, as Steven Crowder calls it. And so that's not going to really hurt him. He wants him gone. And so YouTube announced, like, oh, yeah, we're just going to be demonetizing more people. And a lot of channels suffered because of it. There's a lot of channels that just talked about history and certain things. There's some people that maybe did have some controversial stuff that was demonetized as well. I don't know. I just saw a lot of people complaining, getting emails that, hey, what is happening? And so because of this whole situation, a lot of creators are suffering because this one person is just bitching and whining so much and making all these accusations saying, you know, like, oh, yeah, Steven's been harassing me this entire time. He made this shirt that says, what is it? It's socialism is for fags. And what it actually turns out, I mean, obviously, I see what, I'm not an idiot, I see what Crowder's doing, but obviously it says figs, like, you know, and the A is replaced with the little, you know, the fig root, like the fig tree branch. It's pretty obvious, and obviously Carlos knows that too. Carlos isn't an idiot, and so, but he needs to push that. He needs to make sure you push that so he can really get what he wants. And it's just been a giant mess. So this is where that Vox walkout, that strike comes in. It just, the timing seems very convenient, you know, like it seems like Carlos could have chosen any other time to really bring up that Steven Crowder this, Steven Crowder that, you know, him knowing that deplatform really works in his mind and it's really effective and this is what they need to push for. He seems like he could have done a much more of a bigger campaign to do it, but he chose Pride Month. And then this happens. You know, these Vox members, they're on strike now. They're like, oh, we need better wages or whatever's going on. Now, there is no evidence that they're intertwined, but I mean, this happening one after another seems incredibly convenient. Now, it could be that the striking has been talked about for a long time, and then because Carlos got such a big traction, they're like, okay, let's do it now. You know, maybe it wasn't completely planned out, because how do you know this was going to work out the way it was going to work out anyway? So, but it's just very convenient, and it seems kind of, like, weird. And if it turns out that's the case, then that's pretty pitiful, because there's so many people that got caught, so many people that are getting caught in the crossfires of all this stuff. So many people being demonetized. You know, there's people that have come out, and they're like, oh, this is messed up, and they're putting all the blame on YouTube, and they don't want to blame Carlos at all. But obviously, Carlos is a catalyst. It wasn't his fault. YouTube made the decision to do what they did, but obviously, Carlos and Vox and people like him are catalysts. Back in the day, Wall Street Journal, catalysts. These things, they're the spark. These people, without them, things would be a hell of a lot more smoother. So to not place any blame on them at all is silly. But at the end of the day, it does fall on YouTube. YouTube and Susan Wojcicki or whatever have the power to be like, all of this stuff is fucking silly. Let's all calm down. Let's all figure shit out. Let's all go in our separate corners and let's all make content and try to have a good time. You know, okay, what is harassment? Let's maybe have some clear-cut lines of what harassment is, what hate speech is. But no, everything is ominous and just floating up in the air. And then anything and policies and community guidelines can be changed at just the stroke of a, I guess you can't say stroke of a pen because it's all digital, but you know what I mean. So everything is kind of just a big clusterfuck. They're always just trying to make advertisers happy and whatnot. And then it even seems like, you know, it feels like YouTube and Susan and all the people working there should know that Carlos and all these people that are complaining don't really care. They just want their competition and their enemies vanquished, because that's what it comes down to. Obviously, Carlos is all for, like, Antifa. He says that, oh, they're legitimate protesters and people talking shit about them is not right. He calls somebody like Tucker Carlson a white supremacist. He's saying the whole milkshake thing is a good thing and we should, like, not allow these people to go out and protest people that he doesn't like. And so it kind of shows you where he's coming from, and it shows you how a lot of people agree with that stuff. You know, whether you think, like, the milkshaking thing was funny or not or something like that, at the end of the day, if your political side, if it was happening to you, you would have a huge problem. Obviously, if Carlos and all these people were giving a demonstration at Vox, maybe they were marching outside of their offices or something like that, and people started throwing water and milkshakes at them and stuff and saying, get out of here, you progressive pussies and stuff. You're all a bunch of soy boy SJWs. Like, if that was the case, if everybody was doing that, it would be on headlines everywhere. Everybody would be freaking out in their camps and saying, something needs to be done. We need to dox these people and find out who they are and see if we can destroy their lives. But because, you know, it happened to Sargon, because it happened to people with MAGA hats, it's like, it's just funny. It's no big deal. Yeah, because you don't like them. And that's the biggest problem, you know. They're in these people's minds and ideologues, there is no coexisting. There's no compromise. There's just, oh, we need to thwart these guys. They need to be vanquished. And so the best way to do it is digitally, because, oh yeah, you don't want to actually hurt somebody and then go to jail for it, but you can definitely hurt someone's livelihood. You can definitely try to get someone thrown off and thrown into the abyss. That's the best thing to do to these people. And YouTube is bending the knee. No, I'm not sure how this is going to play out. I'm not sure how things are going to end. I'm hoping that YouTube does reinstate some of the channels that were wrongly demonetized. I hope they get their demonetization back. They figure out things better, you know, because it seems like they obviously just jumped the gun and rolled things out to try to appease these people that are mad. But it's quite clear that this isn't what Carlos wanted in the first place. So it's like, why even try to roll this out at all? It seemed like a very stupid idea to do. Like, it's obviously something that they've been working towards, because they've been doing, you know, letters and issues, and they've been talking about this stuff, and, oh, we're going to do a better job clamping down on hate speech and all this stuff, and then things are getting worse. And so it just became such a clusterfuck, and it's just like, what is the point of this, man? Like, bending the knee to, like, one person or this one company that is just going to make things way worse for you in the end. It's like, at a certain point, YouTube should just be like, dude, chill out, man. I know you're not that angry about this shit. Chill out. Like, have you contacted the authorities about this? Do you really feel like, do you genuinely feel harassed? Have you done anything? I don't know personally what Carlos has done. I don't know too much about him, but I'm just saying, when you're making a big stink on the platform and you're having like a megaphone and stuff like that, it's usually that you're not offended. It's usually that you're angry, you're bitter, you're spiteful, and you just want revenge. You know, you want vengeance. And that's kind of what's been happening, and I think that's fucking ugly. I'm not down for that shit on any side, not really. I think talking shit, banter is healthy. I think being on the internet, that's a big part of it. I think you kind of have to have some fucking will to stay on the internet and take some backlash and some bullshit. And if you don't, it's very easy to just turn it off, go outside, and just do something else and forget about that shit. Very easy. It's very easy to block people. It's very easy to ignore that shit. But that's not what people want to do. It seems like everybody just wants to have their cake and eat it, and I fucking hate it. It's not what I'm about. I've always been more in the center, because I just want people to chill the fuck out and have a good time. Talking shit is okay, whatever. But that's what it seems like more and more. Even people that I respect, people that I've known for a few years online, they're just running to ideological corners as well. And then they're just saying, fucking Crowder this, but Crowder that, and but Carlos this and Carlos that. And I'm just like, shut up, guys. Like, Look at everybody getting caught in the crossfire, man. Like, YouTube is a fucking mess. Like, it's to the point where it's very hard to stay motivated to make legitimate content on this platform, because you don't know what the fuck's gonna happen. You don't know if your monetization is gonna be completely wiped out. You don't know if your videos are gonna be clamped down by copyright. You don't know if your channel's just gonna disappear. I've been lucky, other than just being in the abyss. You know, my channel has been stayed afloat, all my videos aren't demonetized, but just the abyss thing. So I've gotten, like, say, the least bit of bullshit from all the stuff that's been happening, and it still pisses me off, you know, and it sucks. It sucks, man. Like, I don't think there's any solution for this other than just make sure to the creators you diversify your fucking income, because otherwise you're going to be in some huge trouble. But hey, you guys have a wonderful day, wonderful night, wherever you're at. Take care, and just, you know, try not to get too worked up about this shit. It's stupid, it's unfortunate, but man, this kind of seems like a trend, doesn't it? So, you know, all we can do is just kind of just bitch and kind of laugh and be like, okay, all right, why not? Fuck it. Have a good one, guys.